Hi friends, my name is Ratan. So in this video, we'll discuss about the Core Java tutorial. In Core Java, we'll discuss about the topic is called wrapper classes. So the very important topic. So the topic is called wrapper classes. To write some points, let me open Edit Plus. Go to the File menu, click on New Java. So to write some points here. So what the topic here? Let me save this file here. Control S. The topic is called wrapper.java file. Anyway, the topic is called wrapper classes topic, right? That's it. Tell me, what do you mean wrapper class? Any idea regarding wrapper classes? So here, generally the Java contains data types, right? What are data types in Java? We have the byte data type. What are the data types in Java? The first one is what? Data types. So byte data type is there, short is there, okay, int long. To represent the numeric data, we have the byte, short, int, and long. To represent the point values, we have the float data type and double, right? Float and double is there. To represent the single character, char data type. To represent the true and false, we have the boolean data type, right? Total how many data types in Java? Total 8 data types. See here, these are the primitive data types. These are what? Primitive data types. But here, if you take the collection framework, the collection framework is able to store only which data? It supports only what? Object data, right? So the collection framework supports only object data, but these 8 are what? Primitive data types, right? In this case, you must represent these 8 primitives in the form of the objects, right? So what is the point here? We must represent these 8 primitives in the form of what? Objects. So because the collection supports only object data, so the collections, we cannot store the primitive data, right? See, project level everything is object format. So here, in this case, these are the primitives. So you must represent these 8 primitives in the form of the object. Okay, so to represent the 8 primitives in the form of the objects, we required how many classes here? Total 8 classes. Those 8 classes are called wrapper classes. Only one point here. Java supports primitive data types, but these are not part of objects. But collection framework supports everything is object data. So you must convert that primitive types into which format? Object format. To convert these 8 primitives in the form of the object format, total how many classes required? Total 8 classes required. Those 8 classes are called wrapper classes. Okay, small byte is the data type. Capital byte is a wrapper class. Short means what? Short is a wrapper class. Okay, so int means what? Integer is a wrapper class. Long means long is a wrapper class. Float means float is a wrapper class. Double means what? Double is a wrapper class. Char means here the character is a wrapper class. Character is a wrapper class. Boolean means boolean is a wrapper class. Total, how many wrapper classes in Java? Total 8 wrapper classes. See, not exactly only collection framework. See, if you represent the data in the form of the object, you have the some more advantages. Once you represent in the form of the objects, okay, so the objects only we can do the serialization process. That objects only we can do the cloning process. So now, if the object data only, we can do the serialization process. With the object data only, you can do the cloning process. That object data only allows which values? Null values. Like these many number of advantages are there. Okay, the point number one is collection framework supports only object data. If you represent in the form of the object supports serialization process, the object supports cloning process, the object allows what? Null values. So that is the reason we must convert your primitives in the form of what? Objects, right? That's it, guys. See, these all wrapper classes are immutable classes. What do you mean immutable class? The class are two types, right? Immutable and mutable. All wrapper classes are immutable classes, belongs to java.lang package. Okay, immutable means what? Modifications allowed or not allowed? Modifications are not allowed, right? So all wrapper classes are immutable classes, belongs to which package? java.lang package, right? So no, java.lang package. So as you know, what is the root class for all Java classes here? Object is a root class, right? Object is a root class. See, if you take the character class, okay, character class and boolean class. The character class and boolean class, these two classes are direct child class of object. Okay, these two classes are what? Direct child class of object. What about remaining classes? The remaining classes, we have the number class, We have which class here? Number class. Byte, short, okay, integer, long, which one here? Float and double. So these all are child class of number. Number is a child class of object. So character class and boolean class direct child class of object. The remaining all classes, the child class of number. Number is a child class of what? Object, right? That's it. So in front of the video, don't sit idle. Just take the pen and paper, note down all the points. Okay, so I think the points are clear, right? If you represent the primitives in the form of the objects, we have these many number of advantages. Collection supports only object data, C relation process support, cloning process support, it allows what? Null values. And moreover, on the object data only we can call the toString method. Yes or no? We can call which method? ToString method, right? On the primitive data, we cannot call the toString method. So you can call the toString method only on which data? Object data. Right, these many number of advantages are there. Okay, this is hierarchy. All wrapper classes, I said what? Immutable classes, right? That's it. We're clear? Good. I want to create a wrapper object. To create the wrapper objects, we have the two ways. Okay, how many ways to create a wrapper object? There are two ways to create a wrapper object. What are the two ways? Number one is by using construct approach. By using which approach? By using constructor approach. So no, the first one is what? By using which approach? Constructor approach, right? Good. The second one is by using value of method. Okay, there are two ways to create a wrapper object. Number one is a constructor approach. The second one is a value of method. Observe carefully. Constructor approach and what? Value of method, right? That's it. See, I want to create the integer object. To create the integer object, simply can write integer i1 equal to new integer of here you have to pass the 100. We are passing 100 is a primitive value, right? See, this primitive value is automatically converted into integer format, integer object format. This is called constructor approach here. New keyword is there, right? And we have one more constructor, string constructor. So you can make this is a single double quotes also. This is what? I2, right? That's it. So you can create the wrapper object in two ways. Number one is constructor approach. Number two is value of method. Now we are talking about the constructor approach. So to create the wrapper object, integer i1 equal new integer of, here you can make the primitive or you can pass the string also. The primitive is automatically converted into integer format and this string also automatically converted into integer format. Good. That means, sir, I want to create the float object. To create the float object, so float f1 equal to, you can make the new float of 10.5. Tell me here, 10.5 by default which value? 10.5 by default which value? By default it is a double constructor, right? Double value. Okay, this is by default which value? Double constructor. And the float f2 equal to, simply can write the new float of 20.5. F1. This is which constructor here? Float constructor, right? And we can write one more constructor, float F3 equal to new float of, you can pass a string constructor also, right? So to create the float object, total how many constructors we have? Three constructors. Double constructor, float constructor and string constructor. Point is clear, string constructor, right? That's it. That means, sir, I want to create the character object. Character ch equal to new character of character means I think only primitive constructor allowed, right? String allowed or not allowed? Not allowed. Why? String allows double quotes data, but character allows what? Single quotes, right? Why character allows what? Single quotes, right? That's it. So this is a way how to create a wrapper object by using constructor approach. What a second approach by using value of method, right? Value of method is a static method. As you know, static method. Then how to call the static methods? Call the static methods by using. How to call the static method? Call the static method by using class name, right? Good. I want to create the integer object. So to create the integer object, integer i1 equal to, so integer dot value of method. Value of also you can pass the two arguments. One is a primitive argument. The second one is what? String argument. value of also how many arguments you can pass? Two arguments. One is the one is what? Primitive argument, one is a string argument, right? That's it. Here I can pass the 10. What is the second constructor here? We can pass the string data, right? Here you can make the double quotes also, no issues. So I1 and what? I2, right? That's it. So what about the float constructor here? The same way. Tell me how to create the float object? How to create the float object here? So F must be capital here because the class name starts with what? Capital letter, right? Float F equal to new float of, float F equal to new float of 10.5. 10.5 by default which value? 10.5 by default. So double value, right? 10.5 F, which value here? Sorry. This is new operator, right? No. Now we are using which approach here? Value of method, right? Value of method means the float dot value of. So 10.5 float dot value of, right? Here also next line same process. What is the process here? 10.5 F. Okay, third one is what? 10.5 double quotes string data, right? That's it. Very clear, huh? This is a float object creation here. So what about character object creation? Tell me character. You can create the character ch equal to new character of. Okay, character ch equal new character of. Here you can, sorry. Come on, yaar, I'm focused on new operator more. Good. Anyway, what is the point here? Character dot, the method name is called which method here? Value of method, right? Character dot value of, expecting how many arguments? Only one argument. That's it. So finally we decided we can create the wrapper object in how many ways total? Two ways. One is a constructor, one is a value of method. Constructor means how many arguments you can pass, either primitive or string data, right? Value of false almost all same. Either primitive or what? String, right? Exactly. We clear, huh? That's all. See, we have the data types, corresponding wrapper classes, and admittedly corresponding constructors. What are the constructors here? The first constructor is we can pass the primitive data or string data. Short also you can pass the primitive data or string data. Int also primitive data or what? String data. Long also primitive data, comma, string data, right? Simply you can say primitive data here. But float contains how many arguments? Three arguments. Float, double, and string. Whatever double contains how many arguments? Double, comma, string argument. Character contains only one argument here, char. Boolean also contains two arguments, boolean, comma, string, right? That's it. What is the purpose of the wrapper classes here? Representing primitives in the form of what? Objects, right? Wrapping the data into the object format. The process of wrapping the data into object format. Why we are representing primitives in the form of the objects? Because the collection supports only object data. When we have the object data, we can do the serialization process. When we have the object data, we can do the cloning process. When we have the object data, we can insert the null values. When we have the object data, we can call the toString method also. So now we can call what? ToString, right? That's it. Total, how many approaches are there to create a wrapper object? Total, two approaches. One is the constructor approach, second one is the value of method. Okay, so let me do one example, yeah? Example one, the same approach here. What is the main intention this example here? We are converting either primitive or string into, tell me, primitive or what? String into which data? Tell me, primitive or string into? Either you are passing primitive data or string data into which object here? Wrapper object, right? That's it. Our intention is we have to convert either primitive or string into wrapper object. So to do the practicals, go to the file menu, click on new. Okay, so Java. Some of the students are asking practicals based on Eclipse idea. So I decided every topic I will do some practicals based on Edit Plus. I will do some practicals based on IDE also. Point is clear? Good. So anyhow, so first example, let me do the Edit Plus. Next example I will do by using IDE. Okay, good. So to do the practicals, Edit Plus required here. Edit Plus. So to stop using Notepad Plus Plus. That is almost all outdated. But when you write the application by using Edit Plus, a bit colorful, right? A bit colorful or not? So like that. So here what you will do now, I have to write the first application, right? To write the application, just go to the file menu, click on new, click on Java, right? That's it. Here you can write the first application. So what's the application here? The class name is called test. So now declare the class, class name test. Here I want to create the wrapper object, right? But if you want full screen, just click on the full screen here. The first one is one, approach number one. What the approach number one here? What is the approach number one? By using constructor approach, right? Let me do the constructor approach, right? That's it. So to create the integer object, integer I1 equal to, simply can write the new integer of, here you can pass the 10, right? That's it. And if you want, you can create the primitive data also, string data also, string constructor, right? That's it. So integer I1 equal to new integer of primitive constructor. The second one is what? String constructor, right? That's it. System dot out dot println to print the data. System dot out dot println of I1 plus what? I2, right? That's it. What is approach number two? Tell me. Approach number two. By using what? Value of method, right? Good. What is syntax? Integer x1 equal to integer dot. The method name is called what? Value of method. Value of here you can pass the primitive data initially. 10 value. What a second construct, second argument, you can pass the string data also, right? That's it. This is my x2 here. Just you can print the data. System.out.println of x1 plus x1 plus what? X2, right? That's it. We clear? That's it. Let me save it. In local disk E, I'm saving the application. Test.java anyhow. Test.java. Just open the command prompt. So in the command prompt, initially the control is there in which location? Local disk C, right? Just to move to the local disk E, because where is my file here in local disk E, right? Just to move to the local disk E. In the local disk E, how to compile here? Java C, the application name is called test.java. Test.java. Java the class name is called which class? Okay. Java the class name is called, what the class name here? Test, right? That's it. You'll get the 10 plus 10, 20. 100 plus 200 is what? 100 plus 100 is what? 200, right? That's it. Don't think here I'm passing the string. See, your string is converted into which format? Integer format, right? Don't think this is a string here. We are passing the string format, but the string is converted into which format? Integer object, right? Then integer plus integer additionally performed or not? Integer plus integer, which one is performed here? Addition, right? That's all. This is the first example regarding your conversion of primitive or string into which format here? Wrapper object. Primitive or string into which format here? Wrapper object, right? That's it. And while conversion of primitive or string into wrapper object, one small conclusion here. See, for example here, integer I2 equal new integer of 10 you are passing, right? Okay. But here in double quotes, I'm passing T and 10 here. But tell me, string T and 10 is able to convert in integer format or not? Tell me, T and 10 is able to convert into integer format or not? No, right? So here you'll get the exception here. So the exception is called number format exception. Okay. What the exception name here? Number format exception. Whenever the conversion is not possible, okay, conversion is what? Not possible, you will get the number format exception. So value of also same process. Yeah. See, for example, so integer dot value of here I'm passing one. Tell me, one is able to convert in integer format or not? No, right? If the conversion is not possible, you will get which error here? Number format exception. Okay, which exception here? Number format exception or not? Exactly. I think the points are clear, right? Whenever the conversion is not possible, simply you'll get the exception. What is that exception here? Number format exception or not? Clear, right? That's all, guys. So that's all, guys. That's all about the first video regarding your wrapper classes. Okay, just take up to this point. In the first video, what we discussed? We discussed about wrapper classes. So how many data types in Java total? 8 data types. But I won't represent 8 data types in the form of the object. I want to wrap the data type into object format. Okay, why we are converting data type into object format? Because collection supports only object data. Object data only can do the serialization. Object data only can do the cloning process. Object data only allows null values. Object data only can converting to string method, right? That's it. So character class, boolean class, direct child class of object. What about remaining classes? The remaining class are child class of number. Number is a child class of what? Object, right? That's it. Total, how many ways are there to create a wrapper object? There are two ways to create a wrapper object. By using constructor approach. The second one is what? By using value of method, right? So no, that's it. Next one is what? Writing one example. But while conversion, so when you pass the string data, 100 is able to convert into the integer format, no issues. But T and 10 is able to convert into integer format or not? No, right? You will get number format exception. YNE1 also unable to convert into integer format. You will get which exception here? Number format exception, right? That's it. Guys, don't sit idle in front of the video. Just take the pen and paper, note down all the points clearly and do the practicals. Okay, if you have any doubts, you can write them in comment. Otherwise, if you want any material, you can send the request to my mail ID, retnaratna5256@gmail.com. I'll check and I'll forward. So thank guys, thanks for watching. And don't forget to like the video and comment the video and subscribe to our channel to get the more updates. See, every day I'm uploading videos regarding core Java. Just take one book, write all the notes. So you will get one beautiful notes, right? So thank you guys. Bye.